Hello, everyone, and welcome to Tell Me Why, episode 10. And I'm excited to see what comes next. I still have a few questions about this game. Okay, so we put the file in there. We've got a gift. Did we not give the gift to D already? We can't talk to D.
How did you not immediately scarf this down?
You kidding? This is my third helping.
Okay,
I'm
well.
sorry to keep you waiting, Allie, but I really need to finish this before I can break.
I
Anyways, I'm not in a rush.
guess.
We need to eat at the diner. I kind of called in sick, so Tessa's is out.
Okay, is there anything for me to do in here? Apart from talk to this guy I know I've already talked to.
Circles?
Nothing really. Just waiting for D.
Then pull up a chair.
That works. That was a different conversation. We can get Allison to eat.
Dessert for lunch. Pretty cool, right?
Pretty cool, yeah.
I've always had a sweet tooth. Got it from my mom. She baked
What are you having?
trout pie and black radish. I'm on a diet.
A cobbler diet?
Hey, what the hell is your name?
Eat. For a second, I thought she was going to get like the tiniest amount on there, on a spoon there.
You are not kidding about the cobbler. This may be her best batch ever.
Right?
We can't eat anymore. Okay, look.
What you reading?
Oh, about that dock strike and the trouble these folks are causing for everyone else. Ugh. Hate strikes. What is this? Paris, France? Come on.
The only way most people have to get anyone to listen. What are they talking about?
They're talking about none of your business, young lady.
Can we eat more? No. Talk.
Hey, Greg.
Crime in Delos Crossing.
So, what's the criminal underbelly of Delos Crossing been up to lately?
Poachers, vandalism, a few memorable cases of public indecency. Nothing too serious. Which is fine by me. Boring is good. Not like Juno. My daughter's always begging to move there, but that is not happening.
Why? Juno's awesome. There's like actual things to do there.
Drugs. Property crimes double the national average. People come here all the time from God knows where.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Okay, talk again.
Hey, Greg.
Vacation plans.
Got any big vacation plans coming up?
We'll probably go up to Anchorage for Thanksgiving. Linda's sister lives up that way. But I'm also secretly planning a family trip to New York City for New Year's. Been saving for 2 years, and I've got it all arranged under a fake email.
That's really cool. I'd love to go there someday.
It's probably our last big trip before Lauren's off to college, so I wanted to make it count.
I'm sure everyone will have a great time.
An animal. No.
Delos Crossing's most wanted turned out to be some trash bandits.
Can we gift a gift?
Anyway, hun, I'm so sorry to fail, but I gotta run this little guy to animal control now. Probably best I take it.
Can we give gift?
It's okay. Totally, I understand. Duty calls. Thanks. Oh, I brought you a little something to make up for missing your birthday.
There we go. We give gift. Okay, what now? What do you mean? Oh, I forgot to do that.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, how he went and broke into the archive room and pretty much assaulted your uncle. We're all worried about you. This isn't the Allison we know.
The Allison you know?
Yeah. The sweet, smart girl who never hurt anyone on purpose. I know you two and the chief made peace, but I gotta say, it ate at him all day.
We did what we had to.
We did what we had to get what we needed.
All right. I just want you to be careful. I've been doing this for a long time. People, they mostly don't change, even when we really want them to.
Look, I'm really tired. Can we not do this?
Allison, I like you. You're honest, stable, not in trouble. Tyler, if you lose their honor, don't let it happen.
I can't do this.
Oh, are you okay?
Please just let me go. I need air. I need some air.
Okay, what's happening? Oh. Okay, I messed up somehow. I I did not do so good on this.
Wait, am I still breathing? Yes. I'm still breathing. Keep going. My heart's still racing. I think I need to just let go.
What are you doing out here? It's freezing.
I just needed some air.
What happened? What's wrong, little moose?
I think I had a panic attack.
It's gonna be okay. Let's get you inside and warmed up. Let me just talk about what happened.
Okay, so we're going straight up to his office.
Something to make you feel that way?
No. It wasn't him. It was me. I failed him. Over and over.
From here, it looks like you've been busting your ass to help him.
You don't understand.
Allie, got some weight on your shoulders. With Tyler coming back, and your big move. Maybe it's time to ease off some of this other stuff that's clearly stressing you out.
If you mean Marianne, I can't. I owe it to Tyler to see her.
Do you? I don't know why you've always blamed yourself for that. It wasn't your fault.
That's not true.
That's not true, Uncle. I was there.
You were 11 years old. There was nothing you could do. Make that same mistake. You gotta tell this ghost to move on.
Uncle, it was me. I was the one who had the scissors.
What?
Thought it was about time she opened up, you know.
She was sitting tight. So I stabbed her. I killed her.
But Tyler confessed. He went to Fireweed.
We lied. We lied to everyone.
How could you let him take the blame?
It was a mistake, I know. But we were in shock. Tyler wanted to take the blame. And I let him. But we should have told the truth.
Keeping that inside all these years.
I pretty much just bottled it up. And now it's all I can think about. Everywhere I look, she's there. I can't take it anymore.
It's not easy to admit something like that. It takes a lot of courage, Allison. Should have seen it. So sorry. None of this was fair to you two. How are you feeling now? Any better?
Relieved, actually. And really tired. I was remembering something earlier. I don't know if it even really happened. The day Tyler left for Fireweed, did Sam come by with some of our stuff?
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. He did.
How close was he to Marianne?
How close were he and Marianne?
I don't know exactly. But he cared about her a lot. Her death really shook him up.
He was over at our house a lot. Fixing things, chasing off animals. I know you didn't turn up anything about who our biological father was. But did you ever think it might have been Sam?
Ooh. Well, your mom and him were close, so that's a possibility, but I never found any proof, no.
I should go talk to him.
Are you sure that's a good idea? You need to get some rest.
I have to do this. And not just for Tyler. For me too. I love you, Uncle. Thank you for everything. I'll call you later.
Okay, so we're here to see Sam. Okay, out of order, go around.
Uh,
Sam. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What are you doing?
Cousin Billy bought an old motorboat, but that fool drowned the engine, taking her out. Yeah, I told him I'd fix it. Can't put any of the chain or the valve covers back on. So, did you need something?
Wanted to talk.
I was hoping to. I actually wanted to check out your boat, is all.
Back at the house.
Back at the house, yes.
So, what's he gonna do today?
Who knows? So,
what are you doing wandering around in the middle of the working day?
I'm off today. Sam, could we talk now? It's a little important.
Ain't that what we're doing?
Slow. Oh, right. I'm gonna go like that. Okay, so that didn't work. Let's just...
I was over at the station and thinking about some things. You've known us for a while.
Your whole lives. You puked all over my slick denim button-up.
That's a nice memory. Is that what we're going for? I don't know, is that what he could need? That ain't it. In a red can. So where is there a red can that we can actually reach? That's just the map, right? Okay, no, there's not a red can there. Hmm. happened?
I busted my finger with that stupid wrench. Grab me a gauze. Should be in that cupboard over there.
This cupboard? I don't know which cupboard. Because it's like that cupboard over there, but I wasn't actually looking at him.
This article about ocean acidification is really unnerving.
What's that?
Oh, there's an article in today's paper about how climate change is ruining the ocean.
Oh.
I'm supposed to be getting gauze. I'm like really sucking at this.
Find anything?
No. How about that one? Because we can, like, open this one now. Wait, can... No, that's not it. Okay, well, leave. Because we can't do anything else there. I still didn't find a red can there. That's not an answer, Sam.
I wish I was.
What the hell kind of answer is that?
I'm sorry, Alex. But the man you're looking for, he ain't me.
Aww.
Oh, okay. Guess I'll just take your word for it then.
Hey, you got no right coming in here, getting angry at me for something I got nothing to do.
But you were so close.
You two were so close. I know you meant something to her.
You honestly think I would have let you two grow up without a father?
Good point.
No coward.
But you must know something.
I truly don't. Your mama, she never... Look. Just friends. I mean, take a look at old Sam. No woman like Marianne would ever think twice about a guy like me.
I'm so sick of this. I'm so tired of trying to unravel all of Marianne's fucking... I don't understand her. I want to hate her.
So... We're cracking a window first. Fresh air. Yeah, we're not gonna look at that. We're just gonna go and sit. Wherever we can sit. Is here a sit spot? There, yep, there is the sitting spot. Ask to see.
Vaughn has a loft?
Oh, yeah. You didn't know?
Oh, she didn't tell us. Is that a trap door?
Yeah. She had me close the whole thing up. I told her it was going to be real hard to get any hay up there, but she said she didn't mind.
Do you know what's up there?
I could tell she didn't want to talk about it, so I respected that.
Well, we're going to have to empty it out for the sale, so we'll know soon enough.
Well, are you really going to go through with this? It's like I told you, that house meant everything to your mom. It's all we got left. You can't just throw it away.
Let Marianne go.
Look at yourself. That's enough. How long are you going to keep feeling sorry for yourself? Are you really just going to drag Marianne behind you for the rest of your life?
Give it back.
No! I'm sick of watching you play town drunk! For Christ's sake, get it together!
You came here looking for my help, and now you're going to stand there and judge me? Just fine until you two came along, digging up things that just stayed buried.
Fine? Look around you. You're living with ghosts.
Get out.
You're pathetic.
Out!
You took that picture, right? Because you need to figure out where the door is. Tyler?
Hey, you Tyler?
Hey, it's Michael.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Whoa. Hey, let's get you out of the seat, okay?
Was that you?
Is that wise man you?
Hey, like I said, I gotta write my own legacy. So, you in?
I don't know.
Come on, we're burning daylight. Let's go.
Where are we gonna go?
Why go anywhere when we have a perfectly frozen lake right here?
Ice fishing in November?
Yeah. It got cold way fast. Climate change. It's gonna kill us. But hey, fish first. You can walk behind me if you're afraid, though.
You're actually serious.
I am a very serious man, Tyler.
And so basically they're just sitting there.
They left. I never really kept in touch.
Really?
We weren't that close.
Some of them were straight up awesome. But they just weren't close, you know? None of them really got, like, family. I mean, I guess I got pretty tight with my counselor, Aaron. But I already have one.
There's a reason we think of families as people. They keep on sprouting new friends.
Hey, I think I've got a bike.
Yep, are we gonna get it?
Reel him in.
Okay, how do we do this?
Come on, pull up on the rod. Reel him in. Now give it a nice pull.
Yay, we caught a fish! So much better than helping Allison how to breathe properly.
First of all, pace yourself. It's a marathon, not a sprint.
Thanks, Sensei.
Oh, hey, did you want to make solid plans to hit the buzzard hole? The river might ice over soon, so we shouldn't wait too long.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure.
Sweet. I was planning to go Saturday. I'll pick you up on the way out.
I'll set my alarm to first crack of dawn. Hey, so the other day you were talking about your chosen family. How did you find them?
Well, high school can be kind of rough. You gotta hide where you are every second of the day. You know, to a pretty dark place.
I can relate to that.
One morning, my uncle woke me up and I figured we were going fishing or something, and then we ended up outside the Juno Coalition for Equality.
Your uncle brought you to the JCE.
Yeah. He didn't know how to help, so I found someone who did.
That sounds amazing.
You know, even if you don't move to Juno, my offer still stands. The JCE holds a monthly meeting. You meet a lot of good people there.
I think I'd like that.
I'm not sure where I'm going, but yeah, if I'm around for the next one, I'll give you a call.
No pressure. Just letting you know the door's open.
You got anything good in there?
Maybe, but he says I'm willing to share.
Oh, fish time, fish. Okay, much better at that second time. Even though this fish has given me a bit more bother. Yay! Two fishies!
How about them apples?
Nice job. You weren't all talk.
Impressed.
I only see two fish in my cooler.
Side, well, I thought we were on the same page. But it turns out.
Hey, so don't tell our attorney, but last week your sister was almost unbearable. She was jumping up and down with excitement and coming back.
Really?
You better believe it. Look, the last time you saw each other, you were kids. Just because things have changed doesn't mean you can't work it out.
I pushed her too hard.
I know. It's probably my fault. I really pushed her last night. I don't get why she always has to run away from everything.
Can you blame her?
Avoiding the problem doesn't make it go away. She's so fixated on selling the house. It's like she's trying to bury the past. All of it. Even the good parts.
I'm not picking sides here. Okay, but she's been murder house girl ever since it happened. She's got a chance to sit behind her. Start fresh. Shit, I'd be pretty eager too.
I don't really think about that.
I guess I didn't really think about that. I've been so focused on my own shit. It's been hard, you know? Figuring out how to live out here.
You mean outside of Fireweed?
Yeah. When I first got there, all I could think about was getting out. It felt like a cage. But after a while, it started to feel more like a shell. I figured out who I was in there. And now I've gotta work out to be that person here.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, none of us really know what we're doing. Like, shit may look bleak now, but your sister's never gonna give up on you. And you can lean on me too if you want. Just be careful, okay? Got a bad left shoulder.
Fancy bag just for ice fishing.
You don't mix and match. Ever.
Jeez. You don't mess around, dude.
Told you earlier. I'm a very serious man.
Don't you say anything.
Fishy time. I'm hoping three's it.
Now give it a nice pull.
Okay, we're gonna at least have to do this button thing three times. Three times. Catch all the fish with Michael. So it was only three.
Kind of hard to answer my jam. What's up?
How'd you know you were ready to trust anyone enough to put yourself out there?
Okay. That is the hard question. There's not really two ways about it. You gotta be willing to take a hit. Look, I stopped listening to the entire indie folk genre just because I was dumped at a show once. But I put myself back out there just like anyone who's ever gotten their heart stomped on. Because when you meet someone who really sees you, you don't have to pretend anymore.
You still want to risk it with me? We're in total agreement.
I think we're in total agreement here. Yeah? Yeah. I get this feeling like I could say or do anything with you. I feel safe.
You are. Because your sister would kill me if I got you dirty.
Yeah, she would.
So, don't look like you're catching anything with that. You want me to show you how it's done?
Go for it.
This is so cute.
You okay?
Yep, they are so cute. Oh, okay. Allison's on the front steps.
Sorry for interrupting.
No, it's totally fine. We were done anyway.
Catch anything?
Mostly ice, but yeah.
Tyler, I'm sorry for freaking out yesterday. All of this, it's just been really hard on me.
Don't apologize. I was being an asshole. We should have never pushed you. I've been told I have that effect on people.
Okay, so I need to show you something.
What? You're kind of wearing me out.
Can we sit down for a sec? Just at Sam's. He's not our father.
How do you know?
I asked him, point blank.
And do you believe him?
And you took his word for it?
He was crazy in love with Marianne. Whoever set that fire was doing damage control. Sam
True.
Nothing but damage.
I guess he really doesn't have anything left to lose, does he?
Something else. Look at this. This was taken in 1992 when Marianne first moved to Delos Crossing. See that ladder? Sam told me the barn has a loft. He helped her build it. Apparently she never told anyone about it.
And it's still there?
As far as he knows, yeah. What do you think? Should we give it a shot?
We've come this far. In a hidden loft? That's got secret shit written all over it.
It does. Okay, so I'm still playing as Tyler. Excellent. For some reason, I like Tyler more. Can I take ladder? No? Oh, what else would we be going for? Okay, look. What is this over here?
The handle should be behind this.
Oh.
Oh, there it is.
It's opening up.
Cool. Well, let's go and get that ladder now. Yes, I can take it now. Oh, wow.
Can you see anything?
Nope, nada.
Shaved a few years off my life.
Yeah, whoa.
Something.
It's got a combination lock.
Do you think she hid the code somewhere in all this?
Oh, and Marianne, probably.
Well, you want to do this?
Yeah, let's start here.
Yeah.
Story where the goblins tricked the mad hunter.
It looks like
it moves. Oh, some of these parts are buttons. Huh. No goblins.
Yeah.
Why do you think she added that castle in the background?
See the color?
It's not the same title, so I guess that counts as a difference. The mad hunter still has two hands here.
So this was either before the gold lady cut off his other.
That's it. Whoa.
What's in there?
Pictures, letters. Have you ever seen any of these?
All the pictures of Marianne I've ever seen were the ones hanging on the walls.
Okay, read. I can't do this any more. You deserve better than a cliche. Than cliche bullshit. It's not you. It's me. But the truth is, it's all just been too much to deal with, and I realized I'm just not ready. Maybe if we could have dealt with this all on our own, without your mum constantly putting pressure on us, things could have been different. But the damage is done, and it's probably too late for that now. I'm so sorry. You're an amazing person, and you made me feel you've made me a better man. I hate myself for doing this, but I feel like we'll both be better off apart. There I go with the cliches apart. Please don't ever stop being who you are. Here, but I'm gone, Brent. Wow.
Looks like she changed her major to visual arts.
I don't think she actually got it changed. The paper's not signed. It's all wrinkled, like someone tried to throw it away. I can't believe she was a ballet dancer. Marianne.
And a good one, too.
God, that's so not her. Aw, poor thing.
Why would she keep an old drawing of a pet in here?
Wow, I don't think I've ever seen a picture of her that young.
Wow.
The gold lady. That was definitely her mom.
So, did Marianne grow up kind of rich?
Maybe. Would have been nice to have some of that.
Okay, we didn't.
The guy with her is Brent from the letter.
I would guess so.
Okay.
Tyler, see that little light? I think we need to solve this one next.
Okay. Examine.
There's the gold lady again. She's all over the board. There was a figure of her in that stash by the.
Hey, I can move the piece next to the gold lady.
All these pictures. They look like images from Marianne's life before Delos, don't they?
Well, some of them do. Any of the princess dancing, playing violin, spinning wool. I guess this is stuff she did for fun.
Notice
the wise princess looks like she's trying to run away.
And she's being watched by the gold lady.
What's the gold lady do? Is that it?
It's opening.
We did it!
What's in there this time?
Okay, a letter.
Father.
Wow. I hope this letter finds you, but since you didn't leave any contact information, I'll have to send it to your aunt and hope for the best. I'm writing to inform you that your mother passed away last week. We had a funeral reception. And we just had a funeral reception. The house has been filled with people all day, friends, family, colleagues, and church members. It's now 11 p.m., and I'm sitting alone at the kitchen table, surrounded by dozens of trays of food, flowers, and sympathy cards. Your cousin, Adie, brought in a beautiful photo album full of our holiday pictures in La Conna. You're there in all of them, but you weren't here today. We haven't heard from you in 4 years, and we can only hope that you made it to Alaska or wherever you are, and that you and your child are both safe. Your mother had been sick and depressed for years, and you can imagine why. The pain of being shunned by her own daughter, knowing she would never get to see her grandchild grow up. It spread through her body like cancer and consumed her completely. All the suffering simply because she ran away like a temperamental little girl instead of accepting her help when you got pregnant out of wedlock after dropping out of college and without a penny to your name. She only stepped up to help because she knew you weren't ready to raise a child properly, Marianne. A mother's duty doesn't end when her children leave home. Now that you're a mother yourself, I hope you will begin to understand that good parenting isn't about coddling children. It's about providing for them and shaping them into people they're supposed to become, whether they like it or not. I won't trouble you again. You've made your intentions clear. I just thought you should know. Dad.
What the hell? Marianne was pregnant in 1992, before she even got here.
Before us? Do we have a long-lost sibling out there somewhere?
It's possible, but she could have given it up or buried. Who knows?
Yeah, you're right. Do you think we could track down her?
Grandfather she never told us about? I don't think I want to.
You're not at all excited about having more family.
You saw the letter. I don't think we want any part of that.
Fine. Let's keep digging.
Turn?
The weirdest part is how they all seem to love her. Where was prom queen Marianne when the whole town was turning on us?
Yeah. Let's look at the other stuff. Oh, it's a picture of this house, isn't it? From the back.
Is that Carol?
Yeah, and Sam. Look at him. He's so young.
Watchmaker in Juno before she moved to Delos. No wonder she was so handy.
Okay, here is my Delos Crossing Pals number. I let him know you were interested in the house he's selling, Tammy. Yeah.
Some sort of map?
That's
the gold lady's castle. salmonberry flowers.
Hey, that degree in outdoor studies is paying off.
Some sort of clock? This is the princess's house. This looks like a dinner party with the old bear and the very old beaver.
The old bear and the very old beaver.
Another letter?
The princess is lost. Is this from the Book of Goblins?
Not that I know of.
Well, sure looks like it could be.
Oh. No, no, I want to read. Can we, like, go back? Okay, yep. Once upon a time in an ancient and deep forest, there lived a wise princess in a big wooden house. She had made it through the woods into the house with nothing left but the clothes on her back and a single item from her old life, a splendid tiara. She lost almost everything in her desperate flight from the mad hunter. The trees tore the rucksack from her back and shredded her dress and left a pattern of red welts on her skin. But through it all, she clenched the tiara close to her chest, fearing any misstep could cause it to fall from her arms and break. The tiara had its own spot in the big wooden house, a pillow near the window, where the sun would catch its surface to shine and wink. The princess could stare for hours at the tiara, marveling in its beauty and running her thumb down its curves. Every morning she would wake and she would tend to it, polishing its every surface to be sure it shone as brightly as it possibly could. Then she would pluck it up and place it upon her head and walk through the woods, feeling somehow more complete, because what, after all, was a princess without a crown. Every night she would place it on its pillow, give it a kiss, and go to bed. On her way, she would pause and glance back to be sure it was still there. She hated to be separated from it, but she knew it was safest on the pillow while she slept. I still want to read the second page. Wait, what? Did I miss something on that second page?
I can't even imagine how she must have felt. She left everything behind. It's a whole new life for him. And then he was just gone.
I guess having us helped her move on. But when it looked like we were going to be taken away, she just couldn't lose any more children. It really wasn't anything we did.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do with all this.
I don't either. But all I wanted was to understand what happened to her. And now I do.
Yeah. I still haven't seen what's in that chest.
Okay, let's go for it. Can I go back to the book, the letter for the story? I can go back to the story? Read. Thank you. Next page. No! No, no, no. Read. Okay, next page. Right. One night the princess woke to a raging storm. The wind howled against the walls, rattling the windows in their panes. Praying a gust might burst open a window and blow the tiara to the ground, she plucked it from its pillow and brought it to bed with her. All through the night, she held the tiara close, and in the morning, she woke to find herself still cradling it. The storm had passed, and the princess relaxed. That day was the same as any other, though she perhaps gave the tiara an even more thorough cleaning, grateful as she was that nothing had gone wrong. That night, she placed the tiara upon its window, gave it a quick kiss, and went to bed, pausing on her way to be sure it was still there. In the morning, She woke and sensed immediately that something was wrong. In the living room, the tiara lay upon the ground, broken, dull, and faded. Nothing else in the room had changed. The pillow was exactly where she had left it. The window was closed. There had been no storm, no wind, no sign that anything at all could have gone amiss. Only the broken tiara, mute upon the ground. She picked it up and held it in her arms with a guttural cry. But though she tried to fix and polish it, it was gone, beyond repair, and with no shine left. The princess held the tiara through the day and through the next night, sitting in the same spot at the window where she used to polish it. When the sun rose, she looked outside, and her gaze fixed on a sapling. She remembered how the sapling had survived the winter, clinging to life despite the frozen, unforgiving earth. Without a word, she went out and buried the tiara in the ground beneath the sapling, and as the final scoop of dirt fell, the tiara felt truly gone, and with it, the final link to her old self. She could only go forward and find a new place for herself in this world, where she was no longer truly a princess in a tiara and a beautiful gown, and a beautiful gown, but a one woman alone in a deep and ancient wood. And that was how the princess lost her most precious treasure and her title. Okay. Now we can do the box. Set down what? Okay, the box. There we go, Leo. What?
Did it just get darker in here?
Okay.
Tell us any of this.
I mean, it's fucking terrible. That's why. Did we do the right thing opening this?
We did. It's better we know what happened, even if it's hard. There's one more thing I need to see.
Are you sure?
Yes.
We haven't even finished looking through the books yet. I want to look at the rest of the stuff in here. Surely there's more photos in there. Okay, so it just says, Dear Allison and Ollie, we write stories to understand and be understood, but what good is a story without a first act? I'm sorry I kept mine from you for so long, all my love goblins. Okay. Now let's go.
You really want to go? Are you sure we've seen everything?
Yeah, let's go.
Either way, I'm ready for this to be over.
Me too.
It's like, wait for me, Allison. Why are you running? I was just trying to keep up with you.
What are we waiting for? I want to know who was here that night. Let's try and remember who Marianne was arguing with.
Okay. Okay, I'm not quite close enough. Remember.
He's our father?
Of course. It had to be him.
Tessa knew, didn't she?
Yeah, she must have. That's what she didn't want to tell us.
God, Marianne and Tom?
I know.
What should we do?
We have to call him out here and make him tell us what was going on.
And if he won't?
We know his secret. He will. Tom? It's Allison.
Okay, I know this has been a really long one, but I can feel that we're so close to the end. I just want to keep going. I kind of feel like it's not worth stopping here and having another. Not that I've seen a safe spot in a while. But I kind of feel like we may as well just get it over with.
You're our father.
Yes.
You knew how bad it got out here. How little we had. Why didn't you help Marianne?
You mean all the money she wanted? We didn't have anything to spare. Well, that winter was rough on everyone. You would have starved out here if not for all the free food.
Don't act like you had anything to do with that. That was all Tessa.
That's a cruel presumption, young man. Maybe it was Tessa's idea initially. But I supported it. And your mother was happy to live off our handouts.
You tried to burn down our barn and knock Tyler unconscious.
Supposed to be home.
Doesn't excuse the fact that you didn't even stop to help.
What do you want me to say? I panicked. I was terrified that this whole thing was gonna blow up in my face. I had to do something.
You were here that night. You saw Marianne and Tyler. Why didn't you help?
I know it wasn't my best moment. Threaten my life.
So you just decided to let her drown?
I didn't decide anything. Everything happened so fast, I panicked. By the time I got to town, Brown was already on his way out. There was nothing else I could do.
What should we do now? Yep. You have to make this right.
You failed us. You need to make it right.
I'll do whatever you want. As long as none of this gets out.
Excuse me?
You want me to pay for my mistakes? Fine. But please, Tessa can't. This would kill her.
Tessa already knows, Tom.
possible?
It never occurred to you the reason Tessa cut Marianne off was you?
But she never said anything.
You should try talking to your wife. Maybe if you had, we wouldn't be in this situation. Maybe Marianne wouldn't be.
Come on, you of all people should appreciate how troubled Marianne was. She was unhinged. Something like this would have happened sooner or later.
Mm-hmm. You abandoned her.
And you just couldn't risk being there when it happened. Even though it was leaving her to raise kids out here all by herself. None of this would have happened if you'd manned the fuck up.
I made mistakes, but this will not go any further than the three of us.
Why? We know. Tessa knows. Marianne's dead. There's no point in hiding it anymore.
He's afraid it'll tank his campaign.
Yep. Wow. How did she not see you right there by the window, that close to the window? Okay, he fell and he licked his hand. That's kind of a bit weird.
No. No way. You're a fucking liar.
I saw what I saw.
You're manipulating us just like you manipulated her.
Tyler, you're not listening to this, are you?
Be smart about this, Allison. Are you sure you want this to get out? You've got way more here to lose than he does. His name will be all clear, but you... You'll be a killer. And Michael? Hmm? Well, the whole town might turn on you.
Touch me.
Get out of here, Tom. Tyler and I need to talk alone.
Please. Think twice before making any rash decisions. There are a whole lot of lives at stake here.
Leave us the fuck alone. And never come back. Asshole, get to you. Did you?
He's right. I've been having all of these nightmares about that night, and they were a lot like how Tom said. And now, when I try to remember, that's all I can see.
He's trying to mess with your head, and you're letting it work.
No, it's more than that. Ever since we started digging, I haven't been able to shake this feeling like something's off.
Something's off because he put this in your head. Don't let him get away with it.
He might not be lying. We keep getting things mixed up. We remember totally different versions of the past.
Those are just details. This isn't that. She was going to kill me.
I'm not so sure anymore, Tyler.
Oh.
She had a gun pointed at me. She chased me. She said she was going to kill me.
She threatened Tom with those exact same words. With the same gun, on the same thing. The thing you said to Eddie the other day got thrown back at me. Don't you think it's possible that happened here too?
Yes, it's possible. Fuck. I don't know. And we're never gonna know the truth. The second you walk away from something, That's it. Yeah. I guess at this point, you have to decide what you believe.
Me?
Yeah. You need to start dealing, Allie. And that means coming to terms with whatever version of the past feels the most true. No more running. Whatever you choose, you gotta live with it.
Wait, what? Oh, right. Stick to your Marianne threatened Tyler. Wow. I still feel like this is almost the end.
Hey, peep what I just found downstairs. What do you think? Will it have aged well?
By that story. And I almost did.
Yeah. I still can't believe he and Marianne. What the hell did she see in
him? Mm.
Probably just really, really lonely after she was late.
I can never get that lonely.
Listen, with everything that's been going on, it got me thinking. Maybe we should stop using it.
What?
I just don't trust it. And I think we'll be better off without it. This morning, I kept getting these horrible visions. You and Marianne and Eddie.
Visions? Like our memories?
Yeah, but different. With all my worst thoughts. You were in my bedroom saying I abandoned you. Eddie called me a sneak.
I'm sorry. I should have been there for you.
It's okay. I was the one who walked out. I can't let that happen.
I don't think it will. Something's been pushing us to find answers. And we have them. Maybe I'm wrong. And if it stays bad, we can stop. But I really want to keep what makes us.
The mad hunter was forced to remain below the lake with the moon hag, but she did not kill him, because even reduced to just one hand, once again hunt the wise princess and earn back his left hand. And that is the story of how the crafty goblins rescued the wise princess from the mad hunter.
Six months later, wow. Wow, look at Tyler.
I'm getting ready to head out, so last chance. Is there anything you want me to do while I'm in town?
Listen, Ty, you're dropping off the keys with Tina, right?
Yep, gonna leave them at her office on my way to the ferry.
Oh, that's it then.
How's Juno?
How's Juno?
Big and full of people, even without tourists. Michael's been writing up rules for the apartment. I need your support against his whole food policy.
Sign anything until I get there. Okay?
Okay, but you better hurry. If he gets his way, we'll only have one small shelf for junk food.
What? Heresy. I'm gonna need like twice that just for snack cakes after my surgery next month.
I know, right? This cannot stand.
How are you?
How are you?
Good, actually. Really good. You?
Same. You know, everything in the house really cleared my head out.
Thanks for doing that. The observatory really needed me this week. And after everything that happened, I just felt like I needed to keep some miles between the fellows crossing.
No worries. You still loving your therapist?
Gail, yes. I was actually just doing some letter writing she assigned me as homework. It really helped me get some perspective.
That sounds awesome. Did you see the article I sent you about Tom losing the election?
Yes, I sent it right before, so I didn't have time to read it. I did cackle at the headline.
Did you picture Tom's face whenever you went in for a block?
No, but that is a great idea.
Anyways, I'm glad Tessa finally left his ass. Karma's a bitch.
Yeah. Yeah, we gotta go. Oh, nice, we can actually...
Drive safe.
Pretty sure that's the only way possible in the old Allison Mobile.
Love you, Tyler.
Love you.
Yeah, we need those pictures. Take them. From Sam. Okay, well, cool. We can't take it. Well, that would have been nice if we could have taken Sam's letter, you know? Okay. Okay. Apparently there's more stuff, so right. Well, yeah, we need the computer, don't we? Okay, we are taking the computer, right? Yeah, taking the rest of our stuff. That should be it, though, right? Oh, cute. I think this is it. Like, we should be able to leave right now, right? Yeah, let's go.
Well, this is goodbye for real.
You on your break between sessions, but I guess you're going long with another rebel with too many causes. I know I haven't reached out since Fire Week, but I just wanted to say, well, you were right about grief, about it going in circles. Morning, I was out on the porch staring at the fog, and my mother, she just tumbled right out of me. But it was okay. It actually felt good to remember. Call back if you get a chance. I'll see you around. And thank you.
I'm pretty sure this is the end. It is the end of the game. So, if you made it this far and enjoyed the video, please hit the like and subscribe button. Sorry, it's really, really, really long. I just really got into it and I didn't want to, well, I kept missing the save things, to be honest. Anyway, if feel free to leave a comment. I do read each and every single one. I hope you have a wonderful time soon, wherever you are in the world, and I will see you all in the next video. Okay.